Good morning and happy Friday, the Friday before our Thanksgiving break. Hope you guys all had a great Thanksgiving feast. Dr. Gilbert and I loved sitting there serving you. Fifth grade, we missed you, but we know you guys had a good time on your American Revolution field trip. All right, just couple. Oh, let's do this first. Let's do lunch. Lunch today is triple cheese spirals. Pasta. Broccoli in a fruit cup is your lunch for today. I want to celebrate our food drive. You guys did a phenomenal job in bringing in food for our community and bringing donations in for that. Shout out to our first, second, and third place winners. Third place with 77 cans was Miss Beretta's third graders. Nice job. Second place was Miss Simpson's with 110, and I hear there's a little competition between Miss Beretta and Miss Simpson, so looks like Miss Simpson's class is getting donuts from Miss Beretta. And then in coming in first place with 128 cans was Miss Sparks kindergartners. Boy, those kindergartners, they're really showing up. They won the Spirit Day a while back and now they won Food Drive. So I think you guys need to have a challenge there and try and have a little competition with those kindergartners because they are doing amazing when it comes to our challenges. All right, I want to just do a little quick reminder of our Howl expectations, and I want to talk about the Howl expectations in the hallway. Remember, you should be walking at all times and quiet. I hear sometimes when I'm in the hallway and I hear kids shouting and talking to each other, you do remember there's classes going on. So you need to always remember to be walking and being quiet in the hallways and the walkways. That's the sidewalk as well. And then also being in those flash lines. When you guys are walking with your classes, this is an expectation for every classroom to be in a flash line. That is a school-wide expectations. I also yesterday, and I'm sorry, I can't remember her name, but she came up and she had garbage that she had picked up, and I gave her Coyote Cash, and you know who you are, my little first grader, I think it was. And but that's expectations. That's part of being willing. That's the W in Hal is being willing is picking up trash if you see it, throw it in the garbage. It doesn't mean you're gonna give it to somebody and get something, but just picking it up because you know it needs to be cleaned up. Okay, so let's remember those Hal expectations in the hallway, walkways. All right, crochet. We have an action team this started. I know this action team has been trying to get going for a while, so I'm super excited that it is finally going to be starting. If you would like to learn how to crochet, or maybe you know how to crochet and you want to join this action team, then get an application. There is only 10 spots, and this is for third through sixth grade. So this is a upper grade action team. Turn in your applications. Applications are due when we get back on Wednesday. So I would get your application in now because it's the first 10 that get them in there that will be part of this action team. So drop your give your teacher your applications and they can turn them in for you. All right. Dr. Gilbert and I want to wish you all a very good Thanksgiving and let you know that we definitely are thankful for the campus that we have, the staff that we have, and for you Coyotes. We both talk all the time how much we love our school and what we have going on here. So super thankful for you. We hope you both, all of you, have a wonderful Thanksgiving break. And I found a good little song. It's not a movie this time.
For November, but that's gonna change starting now.
One, two, three,
Gobble, gobble, one. Gobble, gobble, two.
All right, so
gobble, gobble, me.
Have a great
Gobble,
Thanksgiving.
gobble, you. Listen to me now. Gobble, gobble, three. Gobble, gobble, four. Gobble, gobble, please. Can I have some more?